Welcome to this 5-minute mini weekend project. And if your weekends are anything as crazy short as mine, we got to get this done in less than 5 minutes today. Here I got a nice little ESP8266 module that I got from Banggood for review. And I chose to get this because it's got pretty much everything I needed in many of my past projects. Like, for example, 18650 battery holder and 4-way joystick. No, it's 5-way actually. You can push it in. On-off switch, USB connector, charge circuit, OLED display, and of course an ESP12F module. It is, I think, although Banggood claims it's a room 2. No, it's not a room 2, clearly. The module comes preloaded with a demo sketch that is, of course, pretty useless for any purposes. What this thing really screams is, turn me into Stefan Kremser's, also known as Basehun's, D author. Now, you got to modify your Arduino build environment a bit, and he's got very good instructions on that. You got to do a bit of work. I've already done that for a past project. But you can also download ready-made binaries. In this case, you should go for the ESP8266 Author 1MB OLED and the 1306 OLED version. I had to insert an 18650 battery in the battery holder because my USB port would not power the module. Now, when I connect the module to my PC, it will come up as a virtual COM port. In my case here, it's COM4. And as the board type, I chose the WeMOS D1 because it's practically the same chip on the board. We also have to comment in the use display setting here. And just go build and upload. Now, if you want to show some appreciation for Stefan's work, you can also get a preloaded board with the author on Tindy. He also got fancy stuff like bigger antennas and all that. I used this project in the past, while it was still breadboarded, for a demonstration in a user security awareness training that I did at the company that I work for. And it was a pretty nice attack because I simply could de-authenticate all the people in the room on the company network. It was quite some fun. So now the thing is built, and it will also take some time to upload the binary into the ESP8266 module. Once that is done, we have to cycle the power on the module, and it will come up with a nice menu that we'll see here in a minute. There we go. So if we power it up, it will come up with the menu, and with this joystick we can select scan, and here comes my home network if we choose that, and we can do stuff with it now, like beacon flood, which will create a lot of beacons that claim to be my home network. I also can go and start the deauthor, and if I activate the deauthor, it just goes